time. Locate the seize any and all funds on the premises. Keep your wits about you, though. I wouldn't be surprised if they made some improvements to their security after your last visit. They out to catch you. Can't say I'm surprised. Bye. relevant coordinates to you. Okay, you know the formula now. So go do what you do. We need a laptop with up-to-date info on the cartel's operations and a new hacking device after our friend, the tech genius, with the terabyte deactivated the last one. Oh, and of course, we'll need another train. The information on that laptop is invaluable. It's gonna tell us the perfect time to strike.
We're gonna seriously fuck you up, man.
Oh, oh my God!
No! These people are nuts.
Calls. as before, I would not expect these gentlemen to hand the keys over peacefully. Be ready.
Masks and armor that can't be traced to us.
influenced by their newfound hatred for you.
Hey!
For our purposes. If you want more options, be my guest. When you're ready, just send me a message confirming the equipment you want to use. Roger that. Received. I'll stash the others in case you change your mind on the day. Dependable as usual.
Enough to return to the same people. Expect heavy resistance this time.
Tessa. You may want to steal all three cars, but only one of them will be a getaway vehicle for the Clock and Bell raid. Same process as last time. You have three options, but can only use one getaway car on the day of the raid. This group is barely off the ground, so it should be fairly simple to steal a car, but it won't be top tier by any means. This neighborhood is typically Lost MC territory. I'm frankly surprised these guys are able to operate here. Don't exactly have state-of-the-art security in place. A locked garage would be the safest spot they can afford to store the vehicle. If you see it, find a way to open it. Once you've acquired a getaway vehicle, deliver it to the garage near the factory. Now they're on to you. I would not underestimate their irritation. Excellent choice. Those are the wheels you want to roll with on a big day. Just send me a message with the vehicle information. This car should provide all the means necessary for a perfect escape. Time to hit up the Clock and Bell outlet on Innocence Boulevard. I'll brief you on the way. Same as last time. Hack the vans and locate the garage. When you've got the location and maybe a uniform, you can hit that place up, wreck their fleet, and grab a key card. We'll need it for factory access. Honestly, so many times that you probably know which depot they use to load the drugs by heart. If you know where to go, be my guest. No point wasting time hacking those vans. Unless you want one of those outfits, of course.
Hey, raise up now!
Okay, keep things quiet and this will be easy. Means the factory won't be expecting us at all. All you gotta do is sabotage the trucks and grab a key card. If you wipe the CCTV, they'll be none the wiser. But listen, if you wanna blow the trucks up, there's no way of keeping that on the down low. You'll be alerting the whole cartel that you're coming for them. But hey, maybe that's your style. silence is a little concerning. Should I have added air holes? Cluck twice if you're in trouble. Okay, good. Now remember, when you burst out of that crate, you'll be in the heart of that operation. How you choose to use the element of surprise is up to you. This is it. Good luck.
Thank you. should have done it. Have you received the safe code? Check the hacking device for the code to the safe. Well executed. Time to go. Okay, I'm listening to the radio, and it sounds like that safe triggered some alarm. They're shutting down most of the rails leading away from the factory. Fortunately, we're one step ahead of them. The getaway car should be right where you left it.
I was optimistic about the operation, but I never imagined it would run so smoothly. We raided the entire drug factory without raising any eyebrows, the cops or cartels. I'm starting to think I picked the wrong career. And look at you cleaning up this town. Halfway to being an employee of the LSPD, huh? If you pocketed some of that cocaine for yourself, you'd practically be a ranked officer. You're clear.
Excellent work. Mission accomplished. Now to the vital matter of payment. As I'm sure you can appreciate, there are certain transactions I can't be party to as an officer of the law. But if I've learned anything from my consociates on the LSPD, it's how to look the other way. Now remember, as far as I'm concerned, you can hit that factory as often as you'd like. As long as you're giving me reasons to keep looking the other way, I'm happy. As you can see from my choice of transportation, my fortunes at the LSPD are also improving. Just got these babies in, fresh off the line. Guess who picked one up? Until next time, I'll let's disassociate.